to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hey Wasatch!
I'm Nora, and I'm your Vice President.
And I'm Parisa, your Assemblies Officer. Attention all Wasatch cross country runners. Please turn in your jersey to Mr. Peterson or Mr. McGowan, and hopefully it's washed, as soon as you can. The pizza party is scheduled for tomorrow, October 18th, in Mr. Peterson's room, room 219 after school. Thanks again for a great season, and see you there. Go Warriors! Attention all Wasatch Junior High debate hopefuls. Debate will be starting tomorrow after school in room 220. If you're interested in competing in debate this year, we will meet in room 220 every Wednesday after school. See you there.
See you there.
See you there.
See you there. Bonjour. French Club is meeting on October 17th at 3 p.m. We will be celebrating the Halloween à la Française.
And now a video from Mr. Yun.
Art contest. Art contest. Art contest. Oh no, wait, that's for Beetlejuice. That's for Beetlejuice, not for that guy. My bad. The PTA has an art contest. Maybe you've seen these flyers somewhere around the school. It's an art contest with a theme to it. It's called I Am Hopeful Because. Also, you might have noticed on the announcements there's been some videos about bullying and how to prevent that. I asked the PTA if we could combine some anti-bullying messages with this contest, and they said yes. Here's a list of the different mediums that you can use. It can be a drawing, a painting, it can even be video. It has to be a video that you do yourself. It cannot be a group video. One person has to come up with a vision. You might have actors. That's fine. You can also do stop motion, or you can do animation. The deadline for the art contest is October 17th. Any videos or artwork that you make for this contest can also be eligible for our spring school art show. So good luck, and we hope to see some of these from you. Make some art!
And here's an important video about leaving the school properly.
Hey, Wasatch Warriors. It is so important to leave school at the end of the day on time. Please remember to walk out peacefully. Make sure that you say goodbye to your teachers in the hallways who are helping you exit the building on time. When school is over, head on home. Play some video games. Take a break. Relax. Take a nap.
And now an important announcement from Miss Gleason and Miss Thompson.
Today we're here to talk about bullying, and I wanted to ask you if you see any bullying at Wasatch.
I do. You know, one of the things that I see a lot is students picking on other students in the classroom, maybe because they're a little bit different than them. What do you see?
I see in math students that tend to get the topic faster than other students, and they will hassle or say mean things because it takes some students a little bit longer to understand. Mm-hmm. And we all learn at our own pace.
Yes, we do. So what do we do about this in our school? How can we help change this culture that we're seeing at Wasatch?
I don't know. I shut it down. And there's no reason that we can't be kind to each other. And if you see someone who's struggling or someone who doesn't fit in, there's no reason why you can't say, hey, can I help?
Yeah, I think, like you said, I do try to make sure that people know that that's not okay. Well, we are, we are one teacher in a class of a lot of students. Sometimes we don't always see it. So it is helpful for students to kind of stand up, right? And say when you see something wrong. If you see someone picking on someone, say, hey, you know, that's not very nice. maybe you should say, use kinder words, right?
Absolutely. And we live in a much different society as I grew up in, being the old woman that I am. I was bullied in school. Mm-hmm. I was very small for my age. As you know, I'm really small still. But I was very small for my age, and I was bullied. I was picked up and put into a garbage can before. I went to use the restroom and had students scribble profanities on my notebooks. Mm-hmm. And when I went to an adult, I was told that that was just part of going to school. Mm-hmm. That bullies exist and you had to deal with it.
Yeah, I mean, I went through a lot of the similar things as you. Again, I'm also a pretty small person, so I got the putting the arm on my head and picking me up, and that's just not appropriate. If someone doesn't want you to pick them up, you shouldn't do that. I think that you're right. We do live in a different society. We should do something about it if we see something, and we should make a change.
And we do have adults in the school now, because we didn't in the past, but we do have adults in the school now that if you feel like you're being bullied, you can go to. You can go to your teacher. You can go to the counselors. They're amazing. Mm-hmm. And you can talk to the administration. But don't passively let it go by.
Yeah. Definitely reach out to those adults that we just mentioned. Make sure that they are aware that something's happening, and we can intervene and make a change.
Because we definitely want school to be a safe and fun environment for everybody.
Yeah. I think a way that you can, in general, help change this culture is if you see someone who is kind of sitting by themselves, or they seem to be alone or left out, do step up. Be the person that invites them to sit with you at lunch, or invites them to play a game with you, or work in your group in a class. And that goes a long way. Those acts of kindness go a long way to make somebody's day.
Agreed.
Is that it?
Hopefully everybody tries to be kind to each other. That's our goal.
Yeah. Let's make Wasatch kind.
What is up, Trivia Tuesday? I am back. I'm your host, Jack Hill. For today's question, we have, who has the most streamed song on Spotify? Is it A, Drake? Is it B, Travis Scott? Is it C, The Weeknd? Or is it D, Post Malone?
A, Drake?
No.
Oh, okay, I have a chance here.
You got this, Laura.
Okay, it's not Drake.
See, I'm supportive.
It's not.
It's probably not The Weeknd.
It's probably not The Weeknd.
Maybe not.
Jack, I can see it. I'm gonna say Travis Scott.
It better not be.
Nope.
Right.
No. No.
Is it The Weeknd? Post Malone.
Nope. It's The Weeknd.
No, you guys got it right. That doesn't count.
Wait, so what? The Weeknd?
Because you didn't get it right. It fell into your hand. It was The Weeknd. Blinding Lights.
Oh, I am
wait,
her. I am her.
I knew it. I freaking knew it.
I won.
Well, too bad.
Welcome to round two. For this one, who has the most streamed album in history?
Taylor Swift.
Let me say.
Yeah, you gotta say it.
A, Taylor Swift.
Taylor Swift.
B, Ed Sheeran. C, Post Malone. And D, The Weeknd.
Bro. Prayers to say it.
Taylor Swift.
Nope.
The Weeknd.
Nope.
Wait, why did I say that?
I forgot who the other ones were.
Ed Sheeran and Post Malone.
Post Malone.
Nope, you guys are horrible.
Ed Sheeran! Oh, I got it right again!
No!
Yeah!
You guys are so bad.
who is the most streamed Spotify artist?
Oh my gosh, how many?
Is it A, The Weeknd? Is it B, Drake? Is it C, Travis Scott? Or is it D?
It's definitely not.
I'm not You gotta check it.
Okay.
No!
Yeah, go off to the three. That's my
I have such a good
the weekend.
Jack.
Guys.
No.
But you just said it was.
Wait, what were the options?
Whatever.
Drake.
I'm making a stop
and
motion.
Okay. It better not be Drake.
Post Malone. Post Malone.
That's what I would have said.
I'm gonna say Drake.
She won.
Yeah! Finally, let's go.
We're done.
Thanks for being here. Have a trick or treat Tuesday, Wasatch.
Better plan to catch this big red lobster man. Let's pop him in a boiling pot, and when he's done, we'll butter him up.
Kidnap the Santa Claus, throw him in a box. Bury him for 90 years, then see if he talks.
Then Mr. Oogie Boogie Man can take the whole thing over then.
He'll be so pleased, I do declare, that he will cook it rare.
That we take a cannon.